New opposition leader Stephen Marshall has begun the job of selling himself as South Australia's next premier. The 45-year-old father of two trying to paint the government as tired, while Jay Weatherill says the Liberals remain dysfunctional. Political reporter James Wakelin is live from State Parliament. James.
Beck, it's been 38 years since the Liberal Party last elected a leader unopposed. And Stephen Marshall, we're certainly hoping that that unity continues. But with new deputy Vicky Chapman linked to party disunity in the past, burying the skeletons of the past will be difficult.
Good morning, everybody. Well, it's my great pleasure to announce...
Taking charge, Stephen Marshall announces the Liberal Party leadership result.
I've been elected unanimously to lead the state Liberals going forward, and Vicky Chapman has been elected as the deputy.
The winning duo then attempting to present a united parliamentary team. Not easy with three former leaders in the room, including Isabel Redmond, who looked to give her new boss clear air. In return, Mr. Marshall appeared to give her fresh air. Among his first policies, distancing himself from Ms. Redmond's 25,000 public sector job cuts gaffe.
We're not going to be warring with the public service whatsoever. They're not the problem in South Australia. It's this hopeless government.
Mr. Marshall stopped short of guaranteeing no cuts, though. His deputy, Vicky Chapman, also looking to move on from her past role in Liberal bloodletting. Difficult when, in a tight contest, Ms. Chapman defeated factional opponent Ian Evans, the man who was leader when she was last deputy.
Absolutely committed to ensuring that Stephen will be the next Premier of South Australia in 2014 and that he will stay there to do the job.
The Premier labelling the leadership battle an intergenerational feud.
It's a disease, and just changing the guy at the top isn't going to cure the disease.
Mr. Marshall's next challenge, rearranging his shadow cabinet. He plans key roles for the man he backed in last year's failed leadership bid, Martin Hamilton-Smith, and today's loser, Ian Evans, who is confident of holding on to the coveted shadow treasury role.
And I'm very comfortable as to where I think I'll end up in a Stephen Marshall cabinet.
So Stephen Marshall will announce that new cabinet on Friday. He says there will be key roles for new deputy Vicky Chapman as well as Ian Evans. He'll also be bringing Martin Hamilton-Smith back onto the front bench, but he will not want to disenfranchise any of those young MPs who have helped put him into the top job. Now, he'll have a challenge tomorrow as well when Parliament resumes. No doubt the Labor Party will be pointing out he's the fifth Liberal leader in 11 years. Beck.
Thank you, James.